Hi, this is John Sonnenberg of artoftravelog.com. And in a previous video, I showed my four Model Ds from Behringer as a polyphonic synth. And it was really intended just to show a friend how I configured them. And then it got a lot of views and a lot of people were complaining about the sound. So this is an attempt to have a little better sound that you can hear with the four Model Ds. And also I've expanded it with the 4 Pro 1. So now I have an 8-voice system, half of them Model Ds, half of them Pro 1s. I think it's kind of nice to have almost a Memory Moog style and a Prophet synthesizer in the same voicing. So some of these oscillators I have and pulse width modulation. Some of them I have just in sawtooth waves. Now, something I want to point out on the Pro 1s, the modulation source and destination, if you have it selected on the wheel, on the original Pro 1, which I have, you use the modulation wheel amount to control that path. On this one, you have to use a CV source for that to work. So I'm using this cat stick with these four voices, and the X direction is the top two modulation, and the Y direction is the bottom two modulation source. If I play a sequence, so it's kind of nice to just have a couple of the voices modulated differently when you're playing around with the modulation amounts. Another thing that I should point out with this Behringer Pro 1 is that it does have some kind of issue with the gate duration when you control it from gate source. And it's a known issue. They're working on a fix for this. For my purposes, I'm just using the decay and release up with a sustain all the way down, so the note duration doesn't have as much of an effect in these examples. So far, this has been configured in an 8-voice configuration. I can also call up a patch where I'm just doing a 4-voice layering. And I have two versions of this. I have one version where, as you play consecutive notes, it's switching the Pro 1s, where Model Ds switch only with changing notes. Then I have another version where you play consecutive notes, and it's switching the Model Ds. And it's nice because you can always have different combinations of these modules. I could set up another configuration where they're in pairs, but I actually like the juxtaposition of the different modules and how you get the different layers. I also have a mode where I have split across this keyboard the different voices. So, for instance, in this range, it's always the same module. Or with that same patch, with the splits, you can assign different synthesizer modules. So that same sequence that I played a second ago, becomes more rhythmic and percussive.